We are discussing another Scala collections, that is our Scala tuples. So what is a Scala tuple? Scala tuple combines a fixed number of items together so that they can be passed around as a whole. And unlike an array or list, a tuple can hold objects of the different data types, but they are also immutable. So for the fixed number of data we are supposed to pass, they might be having the different data types, and the Scala tuples are immutable. The following is an example of a tuple holding an integer, a string, and a double. So val t is equal to 1, so it is nothing but integer. Hello, it is nothing but the string, and double, that is the 13.45. Or we also can define it this way, val t is equal to new tuple 3, 1, that is the value, integer type, there is a string, and another one is the double type of data. So in this way, we can define this variable t in any one of the ways. The actual type of a tuple depends upon the number of elements it contains and the type of those elements. Thus, the type of 99 score is tuple 2, because 99 is of type integer and the score is of the type of string. The type of you are the one for me is tuple 6. So that is a character, R is a character type, the is a string type, 1 is the integer type, 4 is the integer type, and me is the string type. So that is our tuple 6. In this way, we are having multiple different ways to declare. Tuples are of type tuple 1, tuple 2, tuple 3, and so on. There are currently as an upper limit of 22 in the Scala. If you need more, then you can use a collection, not a tuple. So for each tuple n type, where n is ranging in between 1 to 22, as we discussed earlier, we are having tuple 1, tuple 2, tuple 3, up to tuple 22, Scala defines a number of element access methods. So let us suppose, given the following definition, val t is equal to 4, 3, 2, 1. To access elements of a tuple t, you can use the method t dot underscore 1 to access the first element, t dot underscore 2 to access the second element, and so on. Consider here that here this is the element number, there is a 1, it is not starting from 0, it is starting from 1, and so on. For example, the following expression computes the sum of all elements of t. So how many integers are there? 4 integers. So I can access them in this way, t dot underscore 1, t dot underscore 2, in this way up to t dot underscore 4. We can go on adding, we can put it onto a val sum. So let us go for one practical demonstration. There will be showing you some sample codes in Scala written, and we shall discuss more on this tuple and its respective outcome. So here is the demonstration. In this particular code, you can find that we have defined one tuple object, that is a t, and which has got 4 different values, all of them of the type integer. To access each one of these values, we can access it using t dot underscore 1, underscore 2, underscore 3, and underscore 4. We have added them, so the sum of the elements will be obtained. So 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, so it will be 10. We are expecting that 10 will be the required output here. So don't get confused that here we are having this underscore 1, so here is 1, so underscore 2, here is 2. It is not like that. You can put any values there. Whatever you require, and that will be added accordingly. So I'm just going for the execution. You can find that the output is something like your 103. Why 103? Because 40 plus 20 plus 10, here we are having 70 plus 33, so that is 103. So in this way, we have given you the idea that how to define one tuple variable and how to access its members using t dot underscore the respective member number. Thanks for watching this video.